कौन सा करना था, सेवेंथ करना था ना।
हाँ सर,
हाँ तो सेवेंथ वन ओनली, फाइंड द मिडिल टर्म इन द एपी। सो एपी इज 2016-12, 2016-12 एंड इट इज माइनस 1 सेंटीमीटर। तो दिस इज आवर एपी। Okay, so this is our AP. Now we have to find the middle term. So first of all, we have to see how many terms are there in that. So let this AP is having n terms. Okay, so let this AP is having n terms. This is question number 7. So A is minus 176. So we write A plus N minus 1. B is minus 176. From this, we have to find the value of N. A is 20, N minus 1, and B is minus 1. Okay, so you write here A is 20, and B is 16 minus 20, that is minus. So this is our A and B. So N minus 1 minus 20 minus 176 minus 20. 20 equals the same. Okay, so N minus 1 minus 4, so that will be minus 196. So N minus 4 minus 196 by minus 2. Minus minus cancel, 16 and 4 9 56. So n is 49 plus 1, 50. Now see, there are total 50 terms. So if there are 50 terms, then there will be two event terms. Okay, so we can, that also I am giving you, you write down this first. So from this AP we got there are total 50 terms in AP. Now we'll see how to get the middle. So that formula also I will give you now. Write down this.
यस सर, लिख दिया।
रिटर्न।
हाँ सर।
ओके, नाउ वी हैव एन हैज 50 टर्म्स। सो जस्ट आई कॉल दिस
सर, थोड़ा बड़ा लिखो आप क्योंकि छोटा दिखता है।
नाउ देयर इज अ फॉर्मूला इफ देयर आर इवन नंबर ऑफ टर्म्स एंड इफ देयर आर ऑड नंबर ऑफ। So I am writing here both the formula, you write it down, but we have to apply only one formula in there. Now case one, there will be two cases. Case one, this is the formula, okay, not related to this question. Related to this question, we have only one part that we take. So if n is odd, if the number of terms is odd, then we have middle term, we have then which is the middle term, that will be, this is the middle term, only one middle term with the total number 7. So that is the formula. When the number of terms are even, we will have two middle term, and when the number of terms are odd, we have only one middle. So that is the formula. You write down this formula, then I am going to use only this formula. Terms here, we got the term 50 here, total number of terms 50 means even. So we have this formula to be applicable in this question. So write down, then I will write this one. These are the examples of particular. These are the example not related to this question. Huh? This is a completely extra part I have written here to make you understand that if number of terms are even, then we have two middle terms, and if the number of terms are odd, we have one middle.
Yes, sir, we're clear.
Completed?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now in this question, we refer to this part.
Sir, थोड़ा बड़ा लिखो ना आप.
We refer only this part. So here the number of terms are 50. So we will get two middle terms. So middle term one will be 50 by 2. Let me write it here. So there are two middle terms. We will write middle term one is n by 2x term, which is 50 by 2x term. So that is 25th term. So we have to find 25th term. So it will be a plus 24b. So that is the formula. And that term formula a plus n minus 1. That is the n formula. So we have applied that only a is 20. And total term is 25. 25 minus 1 is 24b. So it is 20 plus 24. And b is minus 1. So it is 20 minus 96, so it will be minus 6. So minus 76 and it will turn 2. That is n by 2a plus 1 and term. And that is here it is 26. So I am writing directly. So already you know this 26 term, so it will be again 20 plus 25. So it is 20 plus 25 minus 4. And so it is 20 minus 100. And so it is minus 4. Okay, so these are the middle term of this one. Okay, so this is actually written, it is short, but the question is not that short. Yes, if it comes in an MCQ, you have to write it in a simplest form. Don't to write all explanation. You just simply do it. How can be possibly you can do it. Okay, so, but the method is actually this. This I have done because to understand, so that you can understand this. Completed.
यस सर।
Okay, now question number 8. In an AP, A4 is to A7 is 2 is to 3. Find A6 is to A8. So, 8th question. Given A4, A7. A4 ratio A7. Find A6A. Okay, you find A6A. So, solution, so let us solve it. A4 ratio A7, so we write it like this. A4 ratio A7, so that is 2 by 3. So it implies A plus 3B and A plus 7B. This is 2 by 3. This is given, so let us write it 1.
So find me कौन सा ratio A6 or?
हाँ yes.
So find me कौन सा ratio A6 or?
Find me है A6 A8. A6 है और A8 है. This is A8. A6 A8 हमें निकालना है, तो A6 A8. That can be written as A plus 5B, A plus 7. So before that,
सर आपने सर ए प्लस 7D लिख दिया, भूल से ए प्लस 6D लिख दिया पे, जिसको आपने वन मार्क किया है ना, जिसको आपने वन मार्क किया है ना उसमें ए प्लस 3D अपॉन ए प्लस 7D लिख दिया है, 7 की जगह 6 लिखना है।
हाँ सॉरी सॉरी, ओके नाउ इसमें चलो, इसमें वन मार्क से पहले let us see this part. What so here you write multiplying cos multiplying 3a plus 9b, that is 2a plus 4a. So 3a minus 2a, 2ab minus 9b, so it is 8, that is 3d. So it means that okay, a is equal to 3d. Now we can mark it 1. See here, it is given a plus 3d. It is given a plus 3d upon n plus 6d equal to 2 by 3. First multiply karo, I will write the value of a as a equal to 3d. Now we can see the ratio a6 is clearly now. a6 ratio. So that will be a plus 5d. That is a plus 7d. Now you put the value of a as 3d. So 3d plus 5d. Here also 3d plus 7d, so it will be 8d and it will be 10. So BB cancel and cancel it by 2 tables, 2 4s, 2 5. So ultimately the ratio is 4:5. So therefore, A6 ratio A8 is 4:5. Okay, so it is 4:5. Only here you have to do that. You find a relation between A and D. Once you know the relation between A and D, what is the A? Then in this part, other ratio you just replace A with D or D with A. Then you will the part will be cancelled. D or A will be cancelled, and then you will get the ratio. Completed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, coming to the next question, find the sum of integers from 100 to 500 that are divisible by 2 and 6. So, ninth question, 100 to 500 divisible by 2 and so you must, for this type of question, you must know the divisibility rule. Okay, that already you have studied in your very lower classes, in class 6 even it is there, the divisibility rule for the numbers. Now, do we know any number, any even number divisible by 2? So first of all, as it is divisible by 2 as well as 3, so as we see 2, it should be an even number first. And then 3. What is the divisibility rule of 3? Anyone knows in the class?
Sabka
agar. What is the divisibility rule of 3?
Yes, correct. Absolutely correct. So, divisibility rule of 3 is that if we add 1 and 2,
then the divisibility rule of 3 is if we add all the digits and after adding the number is divisible by 3, then that number is divisible by 3. Means after adding whatever number you are getting, if that number is divided by 3, then the whole number is divisible by 2. So starting with 100, definitely 100, it is divisible by 2, no doubt, but it is not divisible by 2. So we will not take this. 101 will not take because any odd number is not divisible by 2. So there is a no question of taking odd number. Even number 102, yes, 102, even number, and 102, if you add, it is 3, it is divisible by 3. So the first number is 102. Then coming to 104, not divisible, 105, 106, also not. Because 6 plus 1, 7
is not divisible by 2. 108,
yeah, 108. Next is 108. At least 5, 3 numbers, 3, 4 numbers. Otherwise, the D, you cannot see that the D is coming. We cannot confirm that it is D. So merely writing 2 numbers, you will not confirm that it is AP. So take 1 number, 109, 1010, 1110, it will be not there. 112, nahi hoga. 112 bhi nahi hoga. 113, 114, 114.
So 114 ho jayega.
So these are the numbers. We need some numbers from the end also. Otherwise, we cannot find how many numbers are there. So we cannot find the sum. To get the sum, we must need n. What are the total number of terms? So 500 is there. So this is the 500. So we start with this 498. 498. So 500 will definitely not because 5 is not divisible. This you see 4913. It will come 498.
498.
Okay. So is it correct? 498. I think 8, 4, 12 and 921
yes, sir,
is
yes,
correct
sir.
Because 20. Yes, 21 is divisible by 3. So that is the number. Now we can find the total n first. Then we find the sum. Now here we have A is 102. And obviously B is 6. So every one there's 6 differences there. So B is 6. So it is AP. It is AP. So n at term will be 498. Let us find first n. A plus n minus 1 B. Or we have to find the sum, so we can, instead of finding n, yeah, n we need n, n we need, n we need, 498, so a plus n minus 1 b, 498, a is 102, n minus 1, b is 6, 498, n minus 1, 6, 498 minus 102, so it is 4 minus 1, 3, 9, 8 minus 2, 6, n minus 1, 3, 9, 6, plus 6, n is 67. So total number of terms is 67. Now we can apply the formula here. Like one more formula is there, like sum of the n terms will be, if you know the first and the last term, then the formula will be n by 2, a plus n. So therefore, S67. Will be n by 2 a plus n. That is the formula. N is 67 by 2, a is 20, a is 102, the last term is 490. So that will be 67 by 2, that is 600, so it is cancelling 300, so it will be. So the answer is 201. That is the sum of this all the number which is divisible by 2n. Done?
Yes, sir. Ho gaya, sir.
Okay, now next one is find the sum of 20 terms of the AP whose nth term is 2n+1.
सर ये तो मीन के क्वेश्चन
Okay, we'll start the next question. Question number. Insert an arithmetic mean between.
Sir, सिर्फ 5 मिनट बाकी है।
ओके 5 मिनट्स है ना, तो 5 मिनट्स में चलो वी स्टार्ट विद 12th क्वेश्चन। 11 में कल करवाता हूँ क्योंकि इसी कैन नॉट कंप्लीट दिस, ये थोड़ा बड़ा क्वेश्चन है, वी कैन नॉट कंप्लीट दिस क्वेश्चन। सो 12th स्टार्ट करते हैं। फाइंड द सम ऑफ द फॉलोइंग सीरीज, हमें सम निकालना है, तो लेट मी डू ओनली वन क्वेश्चन। आई एम डूइंग द बी वन, 12th बी आई एम डूइंग, सो 12th ए एंड सी होमवर्क, 11th विल डू इन द क्लास, बिकॉज़ 11th एक इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन है, बड़ा क्वेश्चन है, तो 5 मिनट में नहीं होगा। ओके सो लेट अस डू 12th, 12th का बी में कर रहा हूं क्योंकि इट इज डिपेंडिंग फ्रैक्शन 1 प्लस 4 बाय 3 5 बाय 3 अप टू 19 टर्म्स। अप टू 19. So we have to add up to 19 terms. So first of all, A is 1. Yeah, D is 4 by 3 minus 1 means 4 minus 3 by 3. So it is 1 by 1. Therefore, sum up to 20. So it will be 20 by 2 from the 2i A plus n minus 1. Let me write the formula first. That is Sn n by 2 2yj plus n minus 1. So S 20. So it is 19. Up to 19 terms will be S 19. So 19 by 2. 2yj A is 1. 19 minus 1. And B is 1 by 2. So it is 19 by 2. So what LCM will take? LCM is 3. So it is 3 to the 6 plus 19 minus 1 is 0. 2 plus this is 18 by 3. So it is 3 to the 6. 2 plus 6 is 8. 2 plus 6 is 8. So cancel 2 4 the 8 and then you do 76. So S19 is 76. So this 12th question, 12th A and C, this is Google's homework. Okay, this is Google's homework. 11th question will do next day because it will lengthy question. Then let us see 13 is the sum of the term of the length with this. How many, how much minute is remaining?
सर 2 मिनट।
ओके 2 मिनट्स में नहीं होगा, चलो ठीक है, सो आई स्टॉप इट।